We are thrilled when our favorite rappers blow our mind with the bars. We feel closer to them when they mention something they love that we thought only us and our friends were aware of. Who doesn't love lyrics that make us laugh out loud or wish that we wrote them? But how come we don't pay as much close attention to catchy choruses? Maybe we take a melodic hook on a song for granted when it sounds so effortless that we are able to memorize it after one listen, which sounds like the definition of a winning chorus to me. So if your song was a night out at your favorite restaurant, the beat would be the appetizer that you can taste right away, the verses would be the main meal that fill you up with the rapper's story, and the chorus would definitely be the dessert, that sweet spot in the song that gives you an instant sensation if it is crafted correctly. So what are the secrets to how rappers come up with choruses that we can't get out of our heads? Now, before you begin, be sure to subscribe to this channel with notifications because we drop videos every week on exactly how the best rappers create their classics and how you can too. And if you want to become a professional rapper yourself, be sure to pick up our free full-length video course, The Top 20 Songwriting Secrets of Full-Time Rappers, which you can find out more information on by clicking the first link in the video description box below. If the instrumental track is flat and a rapper feels forced to have to write to it, then it's safe to assume that the audience is gonna have to force themselves to listen to the song to begin with. How does the artist know if the beat is gonna be the right foundation for the song and a chorus that is gonna get repeated, hopefully by millions of people, is gonna be on it? Often, it's a split-second feeling where the power of the music just takes over. Roddy Ricch told Rolling Stone that his hands never clutch a pen and pad prior to hitting the studio to record. With the right mood, he is able to become emotionally open to come up with a chorus that captures whatever is going on inside him. A song like Prayers to the Trap God describes what it's like to be in the middle of a federal sweep, but I can't sit up here and tell you that that's what it's like. When I'm in that mode and that feeling in the studio, I can sit there and really visualize what I was hearing and seeing. What was I doing? What was I eating? What was I watching? So if you're an artist learning how to craft a classic chorus, you need to be aware of your relationship to the beat the first time you hear it. The emotion of the music needs to take you over. You need to love that beat like it's gonna be the last song of your entire career. If the beat moves you with no words on it, organically, you will be able to get listeners to feel what you feel in that moment. Many artists get a few ideas down just by humming, freestyling, or what is sometimes known as scatting, a phrase taken from jazz days, to get their creative juices flowing. These initial ideas may be the foundation of a track right then and there on the spot, as Roddy Ricch just said, or they can be saved for later. Some exceptional rappers like Kendrick Lamar stockpile thoughts for songs and choruses even when they aren't currently working on music. Kendrick Lamar told Vanity Fair, "Execution is my favorite word. I spend 80% of my time thinking about how I'm gonna execute, and that might be a whole year of constantly jotting ideas down, figuring out how I'm going to convey these words to a person to connect with it. What is this word that means this? How did it get here? And why did it go there? And how can I bring it there? Then lyrics are easy." On the other hand, artists like 50 Cent do a combination of both, where he was taught to stockpile hook ideas on the spot and then develop the song from there. Jam Master Jay actually started teaching me how to write music. He gave me writing habits because he would have me write the chorus 3 times before he picked one. It gave me the habit as a writer to up with more than one melody for the record. So on Pimp, you'll hear the chorus area, and then you'll hear an area that feels like a bridge on the record, but that's out of the habit that I write 2 or 3 melodies on every song. So the conceptualization period of chorus making should be a painless, fun process because ultimately the fan base wants the chorus, the section they'll possibly be singing for the rest of their lives in the most emotional moments, could be a breeze to interact with as well. Now, approaching chorus writing with less thought and more emotion is one of the key aspects of the younger generation of classic hook creators' ways of creating songs. Juice WRLD is a rapper who found beauty in the simplicity of his hooks. Juice WRLD told Forbes, "I don't write anything. I freestyle everything. So it's just my release. I have not written a song in a very long time. I just go off the top of my head, pretty much." A prolific freestyler, both with the bars and with the hooks, we can all learn a little bit from the creative freedom that Juice WRLD exhibited in his life. Now, I want to see you in the comments. Have you ever heard any other hidden insights into songwriting from your favorite rappers? We try to read every comment, we try to heart every comment, and we respond to most. So I definitely want to get a great discussion with the How to Rap community on courses. I've been your host, Drew Morrissey. I appreciate you watching this video, and I'll see you on the next one.